Today we will start the third part of caring for our soil. In the last class we discussed about the effects of soil erosion and soil conservation strategies. In that we discussed about contour bunding, crop rotation, terrace forming, etc. Now I will continue with the next soil conservation strategies: tree break, shelter belt or wind break. It is a plantation made around the edges of the field or farm. So the plantation made around the edges of the field is called as a tree break. To prevent soil erosion, this tree break is helpful. Advantages of tree break. What are the advantages of tree break? It reduces the speed of the wind and prevents the blowing away of the particles. It controls the flow velocity of water and prevents soil erosion. The trees binds the soil firmly to the ground. It allows the birds to build the nest. It improves the crop yield and quality. Check dams. It is a small dam designed to reduce the flow velocity of water. That will be done by using bags of sand, large rocks. These are placed in the path of the flow of water to prevent soil erosion. What are the advantages of check dams? It controls the runoff of water during rainy season. It recharges the groundwater. It increases the soil moisture in the adjoining area. It prevents the flow velocity of water and controls the soil erosion. And it allows the percolation of water to recharge the aquifers. And this water can be diverted and can be used for irrigation purpose. The last soil conservation strategy, that is judicious use of resources. Excessive use of water results in water logging and soil salinization. Use of biopesticides and biofertilizers increases the organic content in the soil. Social forestry helps in managing and conserving the land. Social forestry is a type of afforestation where in the unused government lands, afforestation program is carried out. Next one, agroforestry. Agroforestry will also helps in maintaining the soil, land, agricultural land and forests. It is a type of afforestation where agricultural activities will be carried out with animal husbandry. Aruvile's afforestation work. Aruvile, it is an experimental township in Viluppuram district. It is in Tamil Nadu. And this Aruvile place is near Puducherry. This Aruvile was founded by Mira Alfasa in 1968. She is a spiritual collaborator of Sri Aurobindo Society. The main architect of this Aruvile is Roger Anger. This is Aruvile's symbol. The dot at the center indicates the supreme. The inner circle indicates our creation and the petals indicates the realization. In 1970, the Aruvile place is like a drought area, but by the Aruvile's afforestation effort, it has been changed like this. It has been completely transformed into lush green cover, forest cover. This is Matra Mandir, a spiritual center in the Aruvile city. It is mainly meant for spiritual activities or meditation center. And this is a botanical garden in Aruvile city. It is wastewater treatment And after treating the wastewater that is used for fields and gardens, forest cover in Aruvila city, and renewable energy source used in the Aruvila. So when they started that Aruvila's work, land regeneration they started, renewable energy source they promoted, and wastewater treatment also they started, and mainly the community, they introduced community participation to bring life in Aruvila. So when Aruvila started, it brought a variety of hopes in the minds of the villagers for a better life. And the people of Aruvila began to work together to bring life in the Aruvila. Some people, they donated their money to Aruvila, and they started working as laborers and domestic help. And they, especially the children, earlier they are not going for school, but now they are motivated to go to school. And whatever the income the people are getting, it was enough to fix their leaking roofs and to send their children. And primary healthcare setup was set up in that place. And a variety of small scale industries was started, like incense making, needlework and leather work. And the women, they started learning some skills in the artwork, and that has increased their family income. Achievements of Aruvila's work. Many areas in Aruvila has covered with lush green forest, and wildlife increased and returned, wildlife returned, erosion is under control, groundwater level increased, and especially some lands have been transformed into organic, productive organic farms. And they started promoting renewable energy sources, and they offered education, vocational training program, and employment opportunities. They developed the homes in such a way that that combine both natural building material and beauty. Tarun Bharat Sangh. Tarun Bharat Sangh, it is an NGO started in Alwar district of Rajasthan by Rajendra Singh for managing the water and the soil resources. It started by constructing the Johads. Johads mainly helps to recharge the groundwater, and also it provides water for domestic purpose, for cattle and for wildlife also. And the work of Tarun Bharat Sangh, especially in Rajasthan, has regreened that drought-like area. Work of Tarun Bharat. So he introduced community participation. They started their work by constructing the Johads, a rainwater harvesting system actually, and soil topography has been done. So actually, by the Aruvila's afforestation work, the rivers that are dried has been revived. So actually the Arvari river in 1940, it was completely dried up, but in 1997 it was revived completely. Achievements of Tarun Bharat Sangh. Agriculture became possible throughout the year. Dead rivers began to flow. Increase in the production of food grains and milk increased the income of the farmers. Nutrition level improved, and even public health also improved. Wooded hills welcomed wildlife. The enrollment of the children in the schools has increased, and the people has agreed for social fencing. So fencing for the hills, that is called a social fencing. So Johads are the traditional water storage system, mainly to harvest rainwater. Importance of Johads. It helps the farmers to cultivate maximum two crops in one season. ground water in recharged and water table has increased. Soil moisture also increased. Earlier, woman has to walk 3 to 4 kilometers to bring water. Now, the woman left with some extra time that they can use for learning skills in art and crafts and to pursue education. The Johad water, it can be used for domestic purpose and to maintain livestock and even for afforestation also. It conserves the soil and the water. By this, we complete the first lesson, caring for our soil. In the next class, we will start with the second lesson, fuelwood crisis. Thank you.